In this gem session, we're going to show how to create a parametric hexagon pattern that we can then use and apply to any given surface and continue to modify and control it. And we're going to use the action sequencer to create the sequence DNA for this pattern. So I'm going to start by creating a basic pattern. And it goes by starting with a simple plane. Can load it from the primitives in Gem. And then I'm going to just go to the plugin sequencer and set it to record so we can start recording the sequence. So it starts by creating a diagonal subdivision, and then we split it with a plus subdivision that connects the center point of every face to the center point of every edge. And we're going to choose no to allow it to pivot about the center. And when it says pivot, it means that the order is originating from the center point. I'm going to visualize that so you can see. Now, I'm going to add another subdivision, which is going to be a simple diagonal subdivision to that. And we can then apply an alternate pattern. So we just go to the right click on this plus menu here and choose alternate. Now this allows me now to introduce another command that will actually apply an echo to edge and reveal the hexagon pattern which is embedded into this initial pattern we just created here. So we're going to do that by, first of all, selecting the color that we wish to use. I'm going to start with the orange color, and I need to rotate it twice to allow it to align back on the edges of our initial subdivision. So what we do, we actually need to use now the rotate and using the face map. And just rotate our orange color twice. This is one, the second time. And then you can see again that all the arrows are again originating or looking towards the origin point of our triangular faces from the first step. Now, what we need to do is to apply, first of all, we just unmap, use that toggle to switch it off. And then we assign it to work on both means main and reference meshes. We can set it to fix or variable. In this case, let's use variable. And let's introduce a certain point by control and click. And I'm going to use echo to edge and just apply, let's say, 0.2 to 0.8 and set it to go. So this is actually something that generated as an initial starting point. Now, I'm going to stop this process. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to revert it back to the first step. And this time, I'm going to introduce additional subdivisions, just using the plus and yes, just to increase the number of subdivisions. We also have our initial target point, so we don't need to select anything. And I'm just going to play this sequence on top of that. So we can see how the hexagon pattern is generated. And you can see the way that the variable aspect of that works and changes the thickness of our subdivision. Now, it means that once we created the sequence that we have here, we can save it, just give it a name, for example, let's call it Hex Maker Pattern Sequence. And we have it now recorded so we can load it for future use. Now, let's try to apply that on a given surface. So I'm going to start with a surface from Rhino. I'm going to rebuild it, in this case to degree one. These are the settings I'm using. And then I'm going to use mesh from NURBS control polygon to get my mesh created and export this mesh with export selected to a wavefront OBJ file, and I'm going to just give it a name here, so we'll call it HexSurf1. And we use polygon mesh, polylines, it's a Windows file, and then export layer names and materials. If we wish to maintain anything in terms of a relationship, we can toggle that off if we don't want that. So we got this created now. We can go to back to Gem. And now we're going to load, clear the targets, and load, of course, our file. So we call it HexSurf. Let's find it here. That was in desktop in my case. So we got the surface loaded in. Now you can see the result. I can even apply now, let's say, thickness or offset by height, for example. And let's say that on the base it's going to be 2 units, and it's going to be 0.4 at the top of that, and just assign the offset to that. So the thickness will be variable as well. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to set my reference points, let's say in this point and this side, like this. And we go to the sequencer plugin, and we can either load if it's not already loaded, or just simply apply what we've got here and get this to affect the existing surface. So we can set it to go. It's now computing the same process on our loaded mesh. Once we have that created, we can then send it and generate a DXF file out of that and send it back to Rhino. So we have the result. Now I'm going to simply load a cube component from a library here, just to get some geometry into that. So you can see how it's closing the hexagon pattern as it gets further away from my points of interest. And of course, if I wanted now to modify something, and I'm not happy because it's probably close too much, I can change that. Let's make this start with 0.05 and goes all the way to, let's say, 0.5. So I updated the pattern, the sequence in the action sequencer. I'm just going to press here to rewind to my starting point and just play that again. So now it recreates the steps of my patterning sequence and using the new parameters I just assigned. And we can get that delivered back to Rhino and use that for any additional design process we wish to explore. So we can visualize it. You can see that it's now responding to the new values, and we can export that as DXF. It's creating a total of 10,080 faces. Once this is generated, we can simply go here to Rhino and go to import that from the desktop. Just created gem model DXF, and we can get it in, and of course we can visualize that in Rhino. So I'm just going to hide the surface and mesh I have there. And you can visualize the result and see how it very easily created and easily controlled. And it now allows me to repeat this process and use this rule-based pattern on any given design I'm going to create.